Hi everyone, I'm not gonna make this video super de-duper long. I just wanted to share something as the Lord has instructed me to share. I know I put a video out at 1:11. I know in the video I said 10:11, but it was 1:11 in the morning. And I had felt this urge to go outside and look at the moon. And the moon was very big, very big in the sky. And Earlier that night, it looked like it didn't. I had never seen the moon look like that. It looked like there was a face in the moon, and it looked like it was a smiley face, like the moon was smiling, and it had three distinct little dots in the middle of the moon, and I had never seen the moon look like that, and it was a yellow color. So that was the start of the evening, and then when I got home later on that night, I felt the urge to go outside, and that's when I heard the sound of the trumpet, and I heard all of these alarms just go off. Security alarm, car alarm, I mean, it was just like alert, alert, alert. And ever since then, I've been feeling I can't even really describe to you what I'm feeling. It feels like time is really, really, really short. And at any moment, at any time, he can come back. And I wanted to share with you, this vision that I had early in the morning, 10:31 to be exact, in the morning, on the 7th as well. Like, all of these things happened on the 7th. Like, it was like midnight, like as soon as midnight came around, like I said, 1 o'clock. I can't even tell you how long I was outside. I was probably outside for like a good hour, maybe. So this is what it says. This is what I heard from the Lord. Excuse the reflection. It's my video. Okay. Wear white as a bride for her groom. Keep thy head covered as not to tempt. Await my return, for I am coming quickly. Behold, I come to retrieve my bride. Be ye ready. Be ye ready. Now, also what I heard was this. Earthquakes. Water covered the earth. People screaming. This is the dream that I had. There were earthquakes in the dream. There were floods. People were screaming, crying, and pleading with each vial. So if you remember in the Bible, in Revelation 16, to be exact, it speaks about the seven vials or bowls of wrath that are to be poured out onto the earth. And it says the true believers are persecuted, but they stay united as a body awaiting her groom. Perilous times are ahead, unlike anything this planet has ever seen. So I want to go back because I want to show you what I saw. Y'all are gonna have to excuse my drawings. If you've looked at any of my other videos, you will know I'm not the best artist in that sense of drawing. I can't draw, but you'll have to deal with it, okay? So I saw this table. It was a very long table, and on the table it had very long glasses. They look like glasses or columns that had, sorry about that, hold on. They had long columns or vials. They looked like long glasses, like a drinking glasses, sort of. And in each glass, it had a different amount. It had liquid in it. And the liquid was different colors, and it was at different levels. So what I'm going to show you is the drawing that I saw, or a drawing, a depiction of what I saw. So these are the vials. These are the, and I mean, it wasn't seven of them. It was like a whole, like, as you could see, it was like, it filled the table. The table was full of these, like, glasses. But you can see some of them are at different levels. See? From there to there. To there, half full, to that nearly empty, almost gone. And they all were of different colors, and they all meant different. They all had a different significance. So I put at the bottom, seven vials, bowls of wrath poured out upon the earth. And then I have another depiction. Trying to, so you could get it. Okay. So this is the depiction of an angel. And the angel is pouring the vial that's up here on the earth. This is an angel that is blowing the trumpet. And the trumpet sound waves are going to the earth. And then down here, there is an empty throne, the empty seat of God. So where Elohim sits, it's empty. He's no longer there. So that is what I wanted to share with you. I'm repenting every day, like, because I know that I fall short, okay? But my heart and my spirit grieves for those who don't know who he is. And so I pray that every day that God wakes me up, that he uses me for that purpose of sharing the gospel. Okay, that's all. God bless. Shalom.